My witness against mankind and my witness to the truth that was given to us to deliver us into eternity is almost complete. The beast has prevailed in the hearts of men, and all except for the small flock. The reason the beast has successfully accomplished killing the truth like it has is men truly do love the darkness rather than the light, just like the first witness, our Messiah, testified to. Truth has no place in most of your rebellious hearts. The truth is our Creator's word that testifies to His righteousness. Therefore, His righteousness has no place in your hearts. He created us to become His righteousness, so you have rejected the reason why He created you. After Adam and Eve ate of the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden, they became naked before our Creator's eyes. They chose to decide right from wrong for themselves by rejecting His instructions. Most of you read this story like it is about them being able to see that they were physically naked after they ate of this fruit. They had eyes to see before they ate of it. They knew that they were physically naked before. They had no desire to cover themselves before they ate of the fruit because they were already covered. After eating it, a covering was removed from them and they were ashamed. Something was just different. Something changed. And they hid themselves and they covered themselves and instead of returning to our Creator for His covering. Covering themselves with the leaves was symbolic of them covering themselves and not being under our Elohim's covering. After they ate of the fruit, they realized that they had transgressed against Him. And there was a change in the way that they perceived things, because He changed things. Something was removed from them. The question is, were they ashamed for transgressing against Him? Or were they ashamed over their lack of physical covering that He now let them perceive? And the latter was the case. They were ashamed of the physical covering because at that point they could no longer see the spiritual. And this is because they were shut off from it. The tree of life represents our Creator's seven spirits. They were cut off from this tree because of their rebellion to His instructions, and so are we when we do. The same happens to us when we transgress His instructions. Yet He still gave them the physical after He had cut them off. He let them go off to live their lives apart from His seven spirits guiding them. But they became naked before His face because they chose the physical over the spiritual. They wanted something different than His ways, than His instructions. They wanted the knowledge, tree of the knowledge of good and evil. They wanted to find out right from wrong for themselves and not hearken to their Creator. And they were given over to seek a physical covering instead of His covering. He even sent them out of the garden, making them a physical covering to show that He provides for us on a physical plane still. His rain falls and His sun shines on the just and the unjust. He allowed for man to go their own way in this manner where they could choose to not hearken to Him. And if they did so, they were shut off from His Spirit guiding them or not given it to them to guide them. He allowed for this because He was calling out and building His temple from our midst, particularly through the descendants of Abraham, through Isaac and Israel, although some others were certainly engrafted into these descendants. All of you who have not hearkened to His instructions or are not hearkening to them are naked before His face and you are shut off from His Spirit. Your physical clothing is not covering you, nor is your false worship to him that is apart from His instructions covering you, nor the make-believe blood that you bathe in, is it covering you? He sees every thought that you have, and your rebellion to His instructions is not hid from Him. Therefore, you are naked before Him, just like Adam and Eve were, or became, how they became. Isaiah was told to walk naked and barefoot for 3 years to be assigned to Egypt and to Ethiopia. Egypt represents the captivity that Israel was sent into. Ethiopia represents the whoredom that came out of Israel that was passed down through Solomon's loins, through the Queen of Sheba and his other lovers that were not of the lineage of Israel. The point of Israel being sent to walk naked for the 3 years was to testify against the shame of their nakedness before Elohim. What was their reaction? Did they repent or did they laugh at Him? What was the reaction to all the prophets? Read about it. Isaiah's nakedness is to be a sign unto you that you are naked before Yahweh's eyes as well, because you are in the captivity. That's what he was referring to as well. It's continued on, except for those who have turned from their rebellion and as he continued to build his temple. The rest of you are naked because you are not under his covering. I have been sent to you clothed in white linen, as the scriptures say that one would be sent to you as a sign to you as well. I've been sent to tell you that you are blind, uncovered, and naked before Yahweh Elohim's face. What has been your reaction? Most of you have laughed or scoffed. scoffed at me, and you certainly have not given ear to what I have been sent to speak. You have scoffed at what I have been sent to speak, yet what I have been sent to speak is an exact match to what the other prophets recorded that the end-time messenger of the covenant would be sent to speak. Your reaction is the same as your ancestors was, who rejected the prophets of old. The same is true of your rejection of our Messiah. He spoke that we must live by his Father's every word. He spoke that the only way into his Father's kingdom is through following him. Following him is walking as he walked. But you reject what he spoke, and you reject the path that he walked on, and you follow a wolf in sheep's clothing that has ravened Israel. Follow make-believe images that came from this wolf, make-believe images of the Messiah. You do this so that you can justify your rebellion to his Father's instructions. You are utterly naked before our Creator's face, but the only shame that you have, if you have any at all, is for the physical. If you have any shame, it might be for your house that you live in, or for the car you drive in, or your clothes, or other cares of this world and things like this. But most of you do not have shame for these things, because the physical is actually your pride and your joy. It's what you're lifted up in, your toys and such. You have covered yourself with the physical, and you have no regard for being shut off from the tree of life, nor any fear of this. Instead, you simply have chosen to believe into a make-believe tree of life to hide behind. You have believed into Satan's make-believe images of our Elohim and his make-believe images of his Son to give yourselves a false sense of security and eternal life. You have no shame for your rebellion for your Creator. You have done this so that you can live your lives as you see fit in the physical, in the here and now, chasing after the lust and the desires of your hearts. You love your smartphones and your TV and your summer houses and all of your father Satan's other distractions. You love the distractions because you do not love our Creator's righteousness, his righteous image that he created us to become. If you did, you would go after that. You would seek, that would be your whole priority, seeking his righteousness, if that's what you love. But your bellies are after something different, the lust of the flesh. Your hearts are wicked and rebellious. You have no fear of being naked before his face. You think that you are hid from his wrath by hiding behind your make-believe images of him and hiding behind your idolatry. You have not hid behind the truth, nor have you even sought after it. You have not sought after his tree of life because you love choosing right from wrong for yourselves. You want to go your own ways. You don't want to listen to your Creator. You actually call the tree of knowledge of good and evil the tree of life in your hearts because you love partaking of its fruit. You think that in that is life. And in doing so, you have made yourself naked before our Creator's face. And now dying, you will die if you do not turn from your rebellion to him. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.